Elder Joe Fielder. Let's say amen as he comes.
Playing with it. Praise the Lord, everybody. Come on, praise the Lord, everybody. There we go. Yeah, yeah. Because what? Yeah, don't play with it, because whatever you put into it, that's what you're going to get out of it. Somebody say hallelujah. Come on, hallelujah. Come on, open up your mouth real loud and tell the Lord, hallelujah. It's the highest praise that you can give to him. Come on, everybody in the sound of my voice, if you can hear my voice, go ahead and clap your hands and give the Lord your best praise. Hallelujah. Come on, Jesus is worthy of praise. Hallelujah. Come on, I'm going to say it again. Jesus is worthy of the praise. The devil is a liar. He thought he was going to kill some of us. Thought we would have been out of our minds by now. Around. Hallelujah. Oh yeah, he turned it around. Hallelujah. He turned a whole lot of stuff around. Hallelujah. Last time I came in here, I can't remember all of what the Lord had done. I'm sitting next to my sister. She said the Lord said what?
The Lord grew my business the last time you were here. That was the prophecy you gave to me.
Hallelujah.
And it came to pass.
Hallelujah. Somebody say, and it came to pass. Somebody say, Jesus is the head prophet. Come on, say it again. Jesus is the head prophet. And we prophesy under him. Now clap it, come on, clap your hands again. Because I don't want you to get mad at me if it don't come to pass. Hallelujah. Get mad at yourself. Y'all ain't gonna talk back to me. Had to go through a, and I'm understanding something. See, a lot of times you have to go through trial and tribulation in order to get out of some stuff. God sometimes will take you through some things so that you will have a testimony that God did it. See, a lot of times people, they hear about what God has done and they just see the results of what he's done. They see the car, they see the job, they see the stuff, but they don't know the road that you had to go through in order to get there. But every now and then, God will say, listen, before you start asking God everything that he gave to Pastor Jones, you better ask yourself, what does she have to go through in order to get what she has? God will talk back to me. Every now and then, you need to say, Lord, whatever you're going to do in this season, don't do it without me, but God, whatever you're going to do in this season, Lord, I want you to do it through me. Do it in me. Hallelujah. Come on, clap those hands one more time. I don't always want to have to go through what somebody else went through in order to get what they had. Somebody said, I want a testimony like Elder Fielder. I want the testimony that he no longer has a note on his home. Yeah, y'all sit on down. I'm a little excited right now, so y'all just, if you bear with me, but just for a second. But y'all listen, had to go through two repossessions. See, it's one thing to be blessed with a car. I can't get no help out here. It's one thing to be blessed with a car, but then it's another thing to see your car up on two wheels about to be rolled down the street. And at the end of the day, it does not matter what I go through, it matters how I come out. And somebody needs to know that whatever you're going through, you're coming out of it. Yeah, it's been rough, it's been crazy, devil's been fighting, and Lord knows he's been fighting your children. He's been killing folk, using black folk as target practice all over the country. But in the name of Jesus, we ain't mad at white folk, we ain't mad at the Arab folk, we ain't mad at nobody but the devil. Because in the name of Jesus, we gonna make this thing, we gonna turn this thing around in the Holy Ghost. Because God don't have some power, he doesn't have a little power, he has all power. I wish I had about 20 folks to clap their hands and say all power. Yeah, yeah. glad to be here. Let me just give honor to God, who's the head of my life. Yeah. Hallelujah. Things ain't always been this easy. Ain't been always this good, but it's good. It's good now. And if somebody says it's getting gooder, ain't good. Yeah. We had to go through a foreclosure only for God to show me that He was gonna keep His word over my life.
Yes.
He promised me. He said, "You ain't gonna never lose your house." Fully. He said, I'm not going to let you lose your house through a foreclosure. Now see, on paper, it looks like I lost my house. Thank you, Jesus. On paper, it says foreclosure. On paper, it says that these other folks own my house. But the Lord told me that I wasn't going to lose it. So I'm trying to figure out, God, other than the fact that I did not pay my taxes on time, other than the fact that I did not, y'all ain't gonna talk back to me, other than the fact that I did not keep up with the payment arrangement, why did you let me lose my house? I can't get no help right there. Am I talking to anybody that had to make an arrangement, only arrangement? Can I get some help right there? Honey, that them folks walked up to my house. And I'm going to tell you this, and I'm not a prosperity preacher, but I'm a prosperity preacher. God's about soul prosperity. Y'all ain't going to talk back to me. See, He will increase your soul, and then He will increase your stuff. But I'm not going to be sitting up here walking around with $1 million in the bank and have a spirit and a soul that's bankrupt. I want to have, if I can't have nothing, I want Jesus. Y'all ain't going to talk back to me. Because when we were staying in a 3-bedroom, I had my wife, I had my daughter and my son, and I had Jesus. And we had more fun in that little tight space than we had ever in our life. And I thank God for the 5-bedroom that we in now, that I now own free and clear. Because although there was a foreclosure, that wasn't all. Come on, y'all ain't gonna talk back to me. The people came to my house and said, "We own your house now. And what do you want to do? Do you want to stay here? Do you want to move? Or do you want to rent?" I said, "I want to buy it." And it's like, well, just, you know, because we can take your house right now. And I ain't gonna, y'all had to excuse me. I was saved, but I was like, I will burn this joke to the ground before y'all take it. I said it in my head. I will burn this joke to the ground. Y'all ain't taking my house. I'm sorry. Please forgive me, saints. Can I just be real? Can I just be real? And the man said, "Well, how much you want to buy it back for?" Me and God had discussed $5,000. The first thing that came out of their mouth was $25,000. But that sounded better than the mortgage that was on the house for $130,000. So I said to myself, you know, that don't sound too bad. $130,000 down to $25,000. And the Holy Ghost had to nudge me in my spirit and say, "That ain't what we talked about. We discussed $5,000. So I told the men, I said, you know, $5,000 sounds good, but let me say, I said, $25,000 sounds good, let's do it for $5,000. They said, "No problem, let's get the paperwork together." Don't get me wrong, I was thinking, wow, but I wish I would have said $3,000. I was a little excited when I said $5,000. But can I say this to somebody? When you are at the wit's end of your situation, be careful with what you're willing to give up in that moment, because you're more than likely going to give up too much. Y'all ain't going to talk back to me. You got people in your life that will come to you and they will ask you for certain things, or you're in a position where you're nervous about life and nervous about what's going to happen next. And the people tell you, "Well, if you don't give me so-and-so, we're going to throw you out. We're going to take this from you, or we're going to take that from you." Be careful with what you give up when you're at your wit's end. Because I remember the woman in the Bible, when she saw prophet Elisha, the Bible said that he came unto her and he asked her, he said, "Listen, sis, can you go give me some water?" Now, he asked for water during the time of a famine. Y'all hear what I said? They asked for water during the time of a famine. That was cool. But as she was going to get the water, he said, "Oh, by the way, can you make a brother some cakes too? Can you make a brother some pancakes?" and if you read it in your real Bible, it'll say some cakes. But can you make a brother some pancakes right quick? And she said, hold on. Me and my son, we have this little bit to spare. We're going to eat this. And then the Bible said, then we're going to die. I'm here to tell somebody, be careful what you say about yourself when stuff don't look like it's going to turn out the way God said it was going to turn out. Be careful what you say over your life. Be careful what you say over your children. I don't care how many of your children out there smoking weed. I don't care how many of them at the club backing it up, jumping it like it's hot, picking it up like it's cold, and making a clap. It don't matter. At the end of the day, I've got a word in my belly that says, for God I live and for God I die, that my children don't even belong to me. But the Bible said that the children are the heritage of the Lord. Y'all ain't gonna talk back. So that ain't my baby smoking weed. That's God's children smoking weed. And when he's ready, he's gonna pull them in. But in the name of Jesus, in the meantime, I speak life over my dead situation. I speak life over my hopeless situation. Y'all better clap your hands and give the Lord your best praise. Hallelujah. Y'all ain't gonna talk back. Y'all ain't gonna talk back. Hallelujah. Sometimes it looks bad for you. Thank you, brothers, for coming. So glad to see you all here. Jesus loves you, and he is the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. And if you live right, heaven belongs to you. Clap your hands for them, you all. Clap your hands. Hallelujah. Thank you, Prophet McDuffie. Thank you for being here. I did not have to ask this, but that's my brother in the Holy Ghost. That is one of the prophets, Pastor McDuffie, that helped train me in the prophetic. When I would be prophesying, and yeah, he can come on up here. Come on, Pastor. Come on. Okay. And when I'll be up there prophesying, he'd be behind me, and I'll be finishing, folks laid out on the floor, and I'm thinking I'm a did something. He said, you ain't finished yet. I said, another thing. And then I'll finish, and I thought I'll finish, and I'll walk away, go to the next. He said, no, you got a little bit more. For that one person right there, and I said, Lord, I can't hear nothing else. But that's the man